Here we have a view of a labral tear or a ligament tear within the shoulder. A probe is used to separate the torn labrum from the bone or the glenoid. This is important so that the labrum can be repaired back to the bone. A motorized shaver is used to remove the soft tissue and provide a bleeding response. Here we are placing an anchor that will allow us to repair the labrum back to the bone. The suture here is colored purple. The number of anchors is dependent upon the size of tear. In this particular tear, we are using 5 anchors, each with 1 suture. Here we can see all 5 of the anchors. Now that we have placed the anchors, we must pass the suture through the labrum to be able to secure it back to the bone. We are using a shuttle needle to bring the suture and collect the suture and pass it through the labrum. Here the suture is being passed, and we are using a knot tying technique to be able to secure the labrum back to the bone. This places the tissue next to the bone so that it can heal in the proper location. The sutures are then each secured independently to be able to bring the tissue back over to the bone. When we get to the top suture, we can see that the tissue has come back over to the bone and is in a good location for healing. The final step is to close our portal by placing another suture. This is done by again putting a suture through the tissue, grasping it, and then passing another suture to secure it. Here we see the final result. The patient would then be put in a sling to allow the shoulder to heal.